Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Senappa. So on this video we are going to discuss about analog inputs. Okay, so we have seen many PLC controller, they have mentioned input of 8-bit analog inputs, 10-bit analog inputs, 12-bit analog inputs, or 16-bit analog inputs. Okay, so what is this 8-bit, 10-bit, 12-bit analog inputs? Okay, so how the PLC is receiving this analog inputs and it is converting to some decimals value. Okay, so if you take 8-bit analog input in a PLC controller, okay, when we are connecting 8-bit analog PLC controller, how we can give the decimal value to scale it, okay, to do the programming. So we will see in this. So if you are first time watching my channel, please do subscribe. Okay, so we'll go to the topic now. If you take any PLC analog inputs, okay, so if you give analog input by simulator or through any sensor, so we can see some value is increasing in simulator or in monitor in screen. Okay, so that value increase from zero to particular value. Okay, that minimum value, maximum value, how we can calculate? Okay, so how we come to know to scale? Because when you take the analog inputs, okay, so now example standard PLC, we have some range. Okay, take example Zilio PLC. So that has two types of analog inputs. One is 8-bit analog inputs. One is 10-bit analog inputs. Okay, so once you have started the programming, inside for analog input, you have to scale it. Okay, so you have to scale it to do some programming. If you are receiving 0 to 10 volt I say analog input, you must know the zero value and the maximum value to scale. Okay, then only you can do some programming or configuration inside the PLC. So how you calculate that zero value and this maximum value? Okay, so what we will do, we'll go to refer the data sheet. Okay, example, now we will see. So before that, we will see what is a bit. Okay, so 8-bit, 10-bit. So what is this bit? Bit is nothing but it's a binary digit. Okay, binary digit is called as a bit. Okay, so 8-bit means it's a eight binary digit. Okay, so if the analog input 8-bit means the analog value will be received from field as a voltage. Okay, that is send as a signal to the PLC in bit. Okay, binary words. Okay, 8-bit, 8-bit binary word. Okay, so the maximum, the minimum is 0, the maximum is 8-bit. Okay, 8-bit binary digit. So we will see what is minimum 8-bit and the maximum 8-bit binary digit. Okay, first we will see in PLC 8-bit analog value how much it is coming, 10-bit analog value how much it is coming, then we will see how the binary is, how the voltage is sending as a bit, then the, how the bit is, that means the binary digit is converted to the decimal value. Okay, now example, now we have this Zilio PLC programming software. Okay, here we have two analog input type we can configure. Okay, so one is 8-bit analog inputs. Okay, this is 8-bit analog input. Another one is, you can see this is analog input expansion is 10-bit. Okay, now we will do the simulation and we will see the value in how much the decimal value is coming when we are giving when we are giving the analog input as a voltage. Okay, simulation run. Now the ID, okay, ID is the 8-bit analog inputs. Now I am increasing. Okay, now it is 0. You can see the value 0. Now I am increasing from 0 value to full value. Okay, so 0 to 10 volt, it is 9.9 volt. So it is showing 255. Okay, 0 to 255. This is 8-bit analog input value. Okay, so this 8-bit analog input from field, it is 0 to 10 volt is given to the PLC. Okay, the PLC will receive the voltage as a bit. Okay, from 0 to 255 as a binary input. Okay, so that binary input will be converted to the decimal value. Okay, each binary input will be converted to decimal input. Okay, from 0 to 255. Okay, the same case 10 bit, this is 10 bit analog inputs. Okay, you can see this is 10 bit analog inputs. The same 10 volt it is given from the field to PLC, but the value is 1023. Okay, so from 0 to 10 volt, the each binary value is means 0 to 10 volt as a received as a binary value. Each binary value, each bits is converted to 0 to 1023. Okay, when it is 8 bit analog input, it is coming 0 to 255. When it is 10 bit analog input, it is coming 1023. Okay, the same case we will see 12 bit analog input. Okay, this is one PLC. Okay, this is one kind of PLC. This is 12 bit analog input. Okay, so I'm giving some value. So I am increasing the input value. It is going maximum 4095. Okay, this is 12 bit analog inputs. Okay, so how this value is coming? Okay, how this analog input is converted to from bits to decimal value? Why this 8 bit analog input is converted to 0 to 255, and this 10 bit analog input converted to 0 to 1023? And this 12 bit analog input is converted to 4095. Okay, now we will see. As I told, each bits, okay, each voltage, the analog input, the analog input value as a voltage, it's given to PLC. The PLC is receiving as a bit, and it is converting bits to decimal, that means binary digits to decimal value. Okay, example now. 8 bits analog input. Okay, it is coming maximum value of 255. How 8 bits means that PLC will convert the 0 to 10 volt to 8 bits analog input. That means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, so 8 times 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 is equal to, just take a calculator and we will do it. 2 into 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 2 equal to 256. Okay, now you can see 8 bits analog input is receiving a binary. Okay, each binary value is converted to from 0 to 256 value. Okay, sorry, 1 to 256 value. That means when we are converting this value, if it is 256 binary inputs, that means from 0, okay, from 0 1 0 also counted as a 1. Okay, 1, then 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 from 255. Okay, if you count from 0 as a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, total 256, so it will come 0 to 255. Okay, so the 0 to 10 volt 8 bit analog input will be converted from 0 to 255. That means total 256 bits. Okay, total 256 binary inputs will be received from field to PLC. Okay, so that is converted to 0 to 255. Okay, now we take again 10 bits analog inputs. How much we have seen? 1023. Okay, 1023. Now we calculate same 2 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2 into 2 equal, that will go 1024. Okay, again The 10 bits analog input will be received as 1024 bits, okay, 1024 binary inputs. That means binary digit inputs that will be converted to the decimal from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 till 1023. Okay, if you are counting from 0 to 1023, so total 1024 binary bits, okay, binary digits, that means binary bits, okay, that is 10 bits analog input. 8 bit means 8 times 2 into 2, okay, 10 bits means 10 times 2 into 2, the same thing, 12 bits, okay, 12 bits analog inputs equaled 4095. If you are calculating 2 into 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 12 times, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11. Okay, that will come 4096. Again, same. If you are counting 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 till 4095. So total 4096 bits will be received and it will convert to a decimal value. Okay. Now we will see the binary value of the maximum decimal value. Okay, for 8 bit analog input, decimal value 255. Okay, so this is 8 bit. Okay, 8 bit binary value for this 255 decimal. Okay, so in 8 bits, this is the 255 is the maximum value, okay, in 8 digit. Okay, so if you are going to 10 digit, then that means 1023. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, so this is 10 digit. Okay, so 10 digit binary number, this 1023 is the maximum number in the 10 digit binary number. Okay, so that is called 10 bit. If you are going 4095, okay, you can see 12 digit. Okay, so this is the maximum value. 4095 is the maximum value of 12 digit binary number. Okay, so that means that is 12 bit analog input. Okay, so this is how the PLC is taking and converting the binary values to the decimal value. Okay, so now when you are doing your PLC programming, if you come to know what kind of analog input, that means if it is 8 bits or 10 bits analog input, so you can, if you don't know what is the decimal value, maximum decimal value, you can calculate easily. Okay, so if it is 8 bit analog input, you can multiply 8 times 2, okay, 2 into 2 into 2 equal value. Okay, that means if you are counting from 0 to the particular the total value, you will come lesser than 1. Okay, if it is 256, if you counting from 0 to 256 value, then it will come 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 till 255. Okay, the same 10 bits, 12 bits, okay, 16 bits. Okay, so you know why we need decimal value, because from direct bits we cannot do any configuration or we cannot do scaling. Okay, example, if our we are measuring one pressure, okay, 0 to 10 bar pressure, okay, we are receiving this analog input. Okay, so we should know the maximum decimal value, then only we will come to know. Okay, 0 means 0 pressure, the maximum decimal value we need to consider as a maximum pressure. Okay, so we should know the maximum decimal value for counting. Some PLC you will come to know. Okay, some PLC you have to check the data sheet. Okay, or data sheet, or you have to go to the help and you do some R&D and all. Okay, so instead of that, you can easily, by calculating, you can find this maximum decimal value of the analog inputs in your PLC. Okay, so when you are doing your PLC programming, you make sure what kind of analog input you are using and what how much the maximum value you are exactly you are putting for your measuring the maximum value. Okay, if you are putting a lesser value of the maximum value, the ratio will come down. Okay, instead of now example 0 to 55, my analog input is 0 to 10 bar. Okay, so it is counting 0 to 255. Okay, so instead of 255, if I put 200, so the bar, okay, the exact bar, you cannot measure the exact value or exact unit of your sensor. Okay, so the maximum value is very important. That means the maximum scaling value is very important for doing the PLC configuration. Okay, okay guys, so now you have an idea. Okay, so thanks for watching. You got an idea, I hope. So if you are first time for my channel, please do subscribe. Okay, so subscribe my channel, and if you are like this channel, please share. And I have posted many other programming videos also in my channel. Okay, you can check the playlist. Okay, so I will meet you in next video. Till then, bye from Senapparajan.